1983 White Sox were, without a doubt, the club with the best chemistry I have ever seen, prior to that or since then. I mean, it was something special to be a part of.
There were some superstars on the team. There were some young players, some rookies, and there were some guys that were some seasoned veterans. But I think in general, just a good chemistry, a good mix.
We had old guys that had been there, and then we had, you know, young guys like me, and it's just, and the old guys would, they, you know, they were, they'd talk to you.
You know, you get guys that are different backgrounds and things like that, but when you come to the ballpark, you know, you're playing as a team and pulling for one another, and you know, I think that's what, you know, made it so special.
It obviously starts at the top. Jerry Reinsdorf and Eddie Einhorn, they had a real belief and a common goal, and they put the pieces of the puzzle in place and let Tony run the club the way he wanted to, showed faith in what he was doing, even though we struggled at the start of the year.
I think Tony La Russa was a big inspiration to us because the way he managed, the type of person he was, didn't take any stuff from anybody on the team. He was just a great manager, and what he did was he brought everybody together, whether we were winning or losing.
He was big on, when we were on the road, getting everybody together and having a party and just stay together and spend time together. And it just carried over into the clubhouse. And we always had a good time in the clubhouse. We were there to do a job and we knew it, but we knew how to relax and have a good time before we went between the lines.
One of the unique things we had that year is we had a kangaroo court. And so it was Bull and me and I believe Mike Squires. And so anybody that did anything wrong at all, I don't care if they missed a belt loop, you know, whatever it was, we wrote them up and we'd have a kangaroo court and we'd fine them.
I even got to find Jerry Reinsdorf one day, and you know, you're finding the boss. But I remember being down in the lobby and we wore shorts to the ballpark. Tony said, just be comfortable, but on the road we had to dress. But Jerry came down from upstairs after a game one night and he sees me in the lobby in a pair of shorts on and he makes a couple comments that I can't really repeat. I said, man, Jerry, that'll get you fined in the kangaroo court. He says, you know what, you're right. He says, I'll match the pot. I said, I don't know if you want to do that. He says, I'll match the pot. How much you got in there? I says, you really don't want to. What's your pot? I said, we have $1,500 in there right now. He says, okay, I'll match it. Next day, we had the money. We had a pot of $3,000 to have a final party on the road because we finished on the road that year, the last 2 weeks of the season. So we did it right.
It was those kind of things that we did as a ball club that got us close.
The chemistry not only existed between the players, but it carried over with the entire coaching staff. We all got along together. There was a lot of times when we were all hanging out together at one time or another, talking baseball, you know, having some laughs and having a good time and so forth.
It just seemed like 25 guys were congregating at the same place, which is very, very big. You don't see that much in baseball anymore because of the nature of the game and the nature of the players today. But I think that's one of the things that's missing in baseball today.
We had great times at those parties and things that went on at the parties. You can't talk about here, but there was, you know, a lot of times we did talk baseball, but we had some great times too. And that's kind of gelled everybody together. I never played with a team before or after that we ever did anything like that.
So the bottom line was in those post games, it's like a graduate school in college, and I really believe that the untold story of that club was the reason we improved so much from about middle June to the end was that we kept talking baseball and learning from our mistakes. We didn't just make them and keep making them, and a lot of it happened having a lot of fun at a party.